Our scripture reading this morning is from Psalm 72, verses 1 through 19. Give the king your justice, O God, and your righteousness to a king's son. May he judge your people with righteousness and your poor with justice. May the mountains yield prosperity for the people and the hills in righteousness. May he defend the cause of the poor of the people, give deliverance to the needy, and crush the oppressor. May he live while the sun endures and as long as the moon throughout all generations. May he be like rain that falls on the mown grass, like showers that water the earth. In his days may righteousness flourish and peace abound until the moon is no more. May he have dominion from sea to sea and from the river to the ends of the earth. May his foes bow down before him and his enemies lick the dust. May the kings of Tarshish and the isles render him tribute. May the kings of Sheba and Seba bring gifts. May all kings fall down before him and all nations give him service. For he delivers the needy when they call, the poor and those who have no helper. He has pity on the weak and the needy and saves the lives of the needy. From oppression and violence he redeems their life, and precious is their blood in his sight. Long may he live. May gold of Sheba be given to him. May prayer be made for him continually, and blessings invoked for him all day long. May there be abundance of grain in the land. May it wave on the tops of the mountains. May its fruits be like Lebanon. And may people blossom in the cities like the grass of the field. May his name endure forever, his fame continue as long as the sun. May all nations be blessed in him, may they pronounce him happy. Blessed be the Lord, the God of Israel, who alone does wondrous things. Blessed be his glorious name forever. May his glory fill the whole earth. Amen and amen.
Amen. You ready?
Yeah.
Okay. We're going to give Gordon some time because we're going to be walking around. Okay, Gordon?
Okay.
So you need to... Today is
Father's Day.
Father's Day. And how are you going to celebrate Father's Day?
I don't know.
You don't know? Did you get a gift for your dad?
Yes.
And since he's not here, can you tell me what it is?
At school, I made pretend paper cards for him because he loves cards.
A pretend car, paper cars. That's cool, because you know he likes cars. Well, you know, Father, what has your dad taught you?
He taught me to be nice.
He taught you to be nice. Anything else? Who taught you to ride a bike? Okay. Who taught you how to take care of the chickens?
My dad.
Okay. Who taught you how to make your bed?
My mom.
Okay. Who helps you with your school stuff?
My dad.
Okay. So it's dad and mom, right? They teach us things. So this morning, I want to ask our congregation, all those people out there, what kinds of things their fathers have taught them, or if you're a father, what have you taught your children, okay? So you're going to be our roving reporter, okay? So men, we'll begin with the men. If you are a father, what have you taught your kids? And you can raise your hand, and Octavia's going to come to you. Here you go. Go sit here.
Respect yourself and respect others.
Okay. Any other fathers? Go see Bobby.
Keep your word.
Keep your word. That's a good one. Any other fathers want to volunteer or anything? Up here.
Good sportsmanship and respect others.
Good sportsmanship and respect others. Okay. They're all pretty good things, aren't they? Yeah. Now, this is open for anybody. What has your father taught you? Raise your hand. Go back to, and then go all the way in the back of the church, okay? And
how to drive.
How to drive. There you go. All the way in the back. Raise your hand again for
my dad taught me how to drive a 5-speed.
How to drive a 5-speed, yay.
Remember them?
Yeah. Oh, yeah.
Up front, Octavia. Oh, you can ask Jane. Go ahead, Jane.
No, I point to
her. Oh, okay, Bob.
How to treat and respect women.
How to treat and respect women. Okay, back over here for Eleanor.
My father taught me how to drive a stick shift, first of all. But second of all, he taught me to love the Lord, going from a tiny, tiny child in a little tiny Sunday school in Lakeside years ago to finally coming to this church. So love of the Lord.
Anybody else want to volunteer?
Choir.
Okay. Go see somebody in the choir. Raise your hand so she knows who to go to.
He taught me the secret to driving a stick shift.
Okay. That seems to be a popular one.
Yeah. Well, he taught me a lot of things, but to love the Lord, to be faithful to the Lord, and to laugh a lot.
I like that one. Anybody else?
They taught me a lot about cars, no stick shift though. How to change a flat tire, how not to run out of gas because he had to rescue me 3 times. I think that was enough. But and all the things, like mechanical things that I do when I fix things and when I see my son fix things, that's my dad.
Yep.
Taught me to be happy and to love everybody.
Come see Gordon. He has one for you.
When I was about your age, I got taught not to stick nails into outlets.
Forget about that, okay, Octavia? Forget he even said that. Well, one of the things... And it really is not a popular thing today. However, can I have a couple men volunteers come forward? Because you get a test today. Okay, John? Bob? Bob Lloyd, can you come forward? I know you can do this. 1, 2, 3. Barry, you brave? And how about Tom? Can you stand up over there?
Oh, do it. To run or walk? No.
One of the things that fathers always taught their sons was how to tie a tie. So let's test the men and see if they can tie ties. Even though they don't wear them that often anymore.
Where's the mirror?
I've done this since grade school.
It's been a little while, but I'm sure still remember.
Haven't done it without a mirror.
Right. That's what Tom said. Where's the mirror?
Yeah. A little short.
Okay, Bob Lloyd's up, followed by Barry.
I give up.
Bob Wallace gave up. Oh, you got yours.
Right.
Kind of.
No, I can't.
And Tom needs a mirror. Now, the question is, have you, in your probably younger days, ever taught any young men how to tie a tie?
Yes.
Yeah?
Several.
Believe it or not.
When you could remember.
Have you all done that?
Yes.
One of the things, that's a sailor-looking tie there, Mr. Greer. Simple little things like tying a tie is something that we take for granted so much. Now, I have to say that it's one of the things that my father taught me. Not that I'm a guy, but it was one of the things that I've taught other guys because they couldn't tie ties. So it doesn't really matter who you are, whether you have children, don't have children, whether you're a girl or a guy. A simple little task like this, once we know it and can teach it to others, is important because it takes more than one person to raise a child. Am I right? It takes a village. And some of these village people will be able to tie ties, and some of the village people will wear polo shirts. So, happy Father's Day. Thank you for all that you do to teach our fathers.
Good job.
I had to call my brother and say, can you raid Dad's closet? But two of those ties are mine. A funny story about the ties is that for one Halloween, and one was a Halloween tie, working at the hospital in the pharmacy, we decided to dress up like the pharmacists. So all the girls wore ties. So I had to teach the girls how to tie ties. Anyway, a lot of fun. Thank you, Gordon, for doing that with us. Gracious God, we thank you for this day, Lord. We thank you that we all have a Heavenly Father, a Father that is always there, will never desert us. This day, O God, we lift up the prayers of the people. We pray for Matthew Godsey, recovering from open heart surgery. We pray for Greg Murphy with a herniated disc that can't move his leg. We pray for Jeff, facing major cancer diagnosis and chemo. We pray for George as he recovers from his knee surgery, and pray, O God, for his quick recovery as well. This day, O God, we lift up Matt Weir, traveling back and forth to Lancaster every week, Lord. Doing this internship, Lord, we pray that you would bless his experience and that you would bless his traveling as well. Keep him safe and keep him healthy. We pray for Blanche and Ed this morning, Lord, as they travel to Lancaster. Lord, that you be with them and give them safe travel as well and bring them home safely. This day, O God, many will be remembering fathers who passed away. So, Lord, be with each and every one of them as they share those memories with one another. Help them, O God, make tears turn to laughter, for we know that all fathers have given us blessings in one way or another. And Lord, this day we pray for those that haven't experienced being a father, Lord, but have fathered other people. Lord, it does take a village to raise a child. And Lord, in our country this day, Lord, we need to depend on one another. So Lord, continue to remind us that we are responsible for one another, that your love flows through us to other people, no matter who they are. So help us, O God, share your love with the world around us. And now, O God, once again, open your word to us, Lord. We have been treated with Kathy's reading of the psalm this morning. And Lord, as we look to the Gospels, Lord, just remind us of Jesus' teaching. For we pray all of this in Jesus' most precious name. Amen. Today we're going to begin with two parables taking from Mark's Gospel, chapter 4, beginning with verse 26. Listen as Jesus teaches. Jesus also said, "This is what the kingdom of God is like. A man scatters seed on the ground. Night and day, whether he sleeps or gets up, the seed sprouts and grows, though he does not know how. All by itself, the soil produces grain, first the stalk, then the head, then the full kernel in the head. As soon as the grain is ripe, he puts the sickle to it, because the harvest has come." Again, he said, "What shall we say the kingdom of God is like? Or what parable shall we use to describe it? It is like a mustard seed, which is the smallest of all seeds on earth. Yet when planted, it grows and becomes the largest of all garden plants, with such big branches that the birds can perch in its shade." With many similar parables, Jesus spoke the word to them as much as they could understand. He did not say anything to them without using a parable, but when he was alone with his own disciples, he explained everything. May these words of Jesus continue to teach us today. Jesus used parables. He rarely taught without them, for he knew that those who were ready to hear would be able to understand his message. It was usually cryptic, yet he used illustrations that the people could relate to, either having to do with their culture or their own experiences. Because of that, many people today don't have the ears to hear his messages. I think sometimes we're just always in a rush, and we don't take time to understand or even think about something that takes brain power. We are a microwave society. 3 minutes or less, and it's okay. More than that, the things get questionable. We also live in a YouTube society. If you need to know how to do just about anything, you can go to YouTube and watch a video. In fact, there is one called YouTube Dad, where he shares all the lessons that he believes dads should teach their kids. And he has millions of followers. Now, YouTube can be both good and bad in my eyes. Good because it can give you a ton of instruction without interacting with another human being. And to me, that's the bad part. Instead of strengthening communication skills, instead of building relationships with fathers or parents or others, too many are just relying on the internet. Jesus didn't have that problem. Whenever Jesus taught, the crowds followed him, whether they wanted healing for themselves or a loved one, whether they wanted food or just wanted wisdom, they actually had to see and hear Jesus. Now, they didn't always understand, thanks to the parables, but little by little, as they developed a relationship with Jesus, they came to understand his messages. Even though his way of speaking was unorthodox, per se, using parables or stories, eventually, when the time was right, they understood. Even the disciples sometimes had to ask for explanations so they could be truly disciples. And as our scripture said this morning, when Jesus was with his disciples, he would further explain himself. Now, another thing I want to remind you of today, there are also times of discipline. You like discipline, Octavia? Huh? Many people will say no. When things went wrong, Jesus corrected even the disciples. They all got schooled many times. And just because they were disciplined didn't mean that Jesus didn't love them. For sometimes we all need some discipline. In the Old Testament, we see God disciplining the people as well. And I have to say, for the most part, God's discipline was pretty harsh. Remember Sodom and Gomorrah? Don't look back. That was a very harsh lesson to learn, wasn't it? Let's look to Jonah. Go to Nineveh. Jonah has other ideas, and although he ended up doing what he was asked to do eventually, he had some rough timeouts in the belly of a whale. This being Father's Day, I want to remind us all that being a father isn't easy. Today isn't about who does more, mothers or fathers, or who has it easier. Today is about remembering and thanking God for the fathers we have had in our lives. And yes, I know that some fathers are really uncles or big brothers, but whoever that role model was for you, take time today to give thanks for the lessons, for the discipline, for the person that we are today has been shaped in some way or form by a father we have had in our lives. And I know we all didn't experience the father knows best kind of dad. When I began ministry, I soon discovered that I'd learned what to do from some mentors, and I learned what not to do from some other pastors. You see, we learn from both the good and the bad, but they are from interactions, they are from relationships as well. I know some of you experience the, I wish he was my father instead of the one I have. Usually teenage years, right? It's always greener on the other side of the fence. Just remember, the father you have in heaven will always be the perfect father. The father in heaven will always guide you and love you, for we know that God is love. Yet that heavenly Father will also be the one who will judge you when you meet him face to face. The God who knows all and sees all is the God who wants you to know him. Don't wait until you're standing before him, for he may say, "You're a stranger to me." Relationships are Relationships that are forced are not true relationships. You see, as adults, we choose who we allow into our lives. Choose to be in a relationship with those who have shaped your life. The family that you were raised in, and perhaps the extended family that was both near and far. Cherish the good. Learn from the not so good. And don't forget your Father in heaven. And while you are about giving thanks for all that you received, think of ways that you can pass it on to others. This generation needs what you have experienced. This generation needs to know that even though your life is not perfect, life is good and can be good and will be good for them as well. So whatever you choose to do this Father's Day, make sure you include a time of giving thanks. Thanks be to God for being our Heavenly Father that will never fail. Amen?
Amen.
Amen. My prayer for all of us today is that we take the joy that God has put into our hearts and share it with those around us, especially this day. Be grateful for what you have experienced in life, and be grateful that you have stories that you can share with others. Let's share the love of Christ. Amen. Amen.